Archaeologists find iPhone-like belt buckle, buried in a grave in Russian Atlantis. To archaeologist Pavel Yuse, the striking new find resembled a modern smartphone. The black rectangular object was located in a burial site known as the Russian Atlantis, in mountainous Republic of Tuva, for it only appears from underwater for few weeks a year. Archaeologists jokingly nicknamed the ancient female Natasha, while her accessory was called an iPhone. Natasha's burial with a Xungnu-era iPhone remains one of the most interesting at this burial site, Pavel Lius said in a new publication summarizing results of several years of recent archaeological expeditions to the Ala-Tey burial site. In fact, the discovery is a large 18 cm by 9 cm, chic belt buckle made of gemstone jet with inlaid decorations of turquoise, carnelian and mother of pearl. The woman's belt was decorated with Chinese wazi coins which help the scientists to date it. They believe it might be up to 2,137 years old because this is when such coins were first minted. The find was made in 2016 at the Ala-Tey necropolis in the Siam Sea. This is a giant man-made reservoir on the Yenai River upstream of the Siano-Shushanskaya Dam, Russia's biggest power plant. The water drains in May and June each year, exposing the vast desert-like floor. Graves have been found here dating from the Bronze Age to the time of Genghis Khan. Earlier, two partly mummified prehistoric fashionistas, buried with the tools of their trade, were unearthed. One called Sleeping Beauty, dressed in silk for the afterlife, was at first believed to be a priestess. Now she is thought to have been a leather designer. The second was a weaver laid to rest with her wooden spindle packed inside a sewing bag. As many as 110 burials appeared on an island in the reservoir at Ala-Tey site. "This site is a scientific sensation," said Dr. Marina Kilyunovskaya from the St. Petersburg Institute of Material History Culture, who leads the Tuva archaeological expedition. "We are incredibly lucky to have found these burials of rich nomads that were not disturbed by ancient grave robbers." Pavel Lius is from the Society for the Exploration of Eurasia. Tuva archaeological rescue expedition in flooded areas is possible thanks to a grant from the Russian Geographical Society, and help from Society for the Exploration of Eurasia, Switzerland.